From here, I think 7,800 miles. From my home altogether, 16 plus 3 plus.
Do you have any thoughts?
I think I have my story.
What's your story?
When they moved in to my apartment. And I even have a Snapchat, it's really cute. Of Bella, like, choosing them over me.
If I take a train from my, no, from my place, there is a no train. Okay. I come to a station by car, it takes 3 hours. From there, overnight train, 10 hours.
I feel like I'm not mentally on.
They're not going to use the whole thing.
Oh, thank goodness.
I really don't have any stories. I just love the whole time. I don't have any stories.
And from Chennai, that is the capital city of my province, from there to come to Delhi to catch an international flight, it takes 3 hours. And layover is 5 hours. Then 14 and a half hours, but I think the pilot was very smart. He landed 1 hour before.
Okay.
Yeah, in Washington, D.C.
This is the same thing my family's doing over there.
Go on Effie's page when they're friends and go.
Boop. I showed it to you guys. It worked so easy.
You invited,
invited them again.
Yeah.
You're like, you're
no, but
not
I'm
invited.
Saying you won't see it because you're not invited to it.
This is what happens. This is what happens.
You love that.
When you live,
you can break the fourth
we have people in three different countries.
Yes.
Effie, you better not laugh, because
if you start laughing,
Zana's going to, 2 days ago, she was like, I swear, if any of you laugh, I'm going to be so angry. And we were like...
as she was saying that, Linky was laughing so hard, like, so hard. It was so funny.
You better not make eye contact with me.
It's Lou. It's Lou that's going to tick you off.
Yeah, I can't.
So I spent Christmas with them in my freshman year. It was really fun, like just experiencing everything, doing me around campus, and I'd always being there for me. So yeah, it was fun.
I think the wedding was beautiful. I love the way it turned out. I thought it was elegant and Christ-centered and exactly what a wedding should be. In 2018, he started coming to school here and we kind of adopted him as an additional child. And then during COVID, he came to our house in May of 2020 and he never left. He stayed all summer long. I think he was there about 4 months and we had a wonderful summer. And we really got to know him.
Minister of the Gospel, to pronounce you husband and wife, and for me to kiss your bride.
My freshman year, Liz used to work at Starbucks. One day I was walking in and I saw this guy ordering his coffee. As I got to the table to do my order, I saw him left and he was standing in the corner. Didn't think much of it. bought my coffee, and then later on the week, the same thing, came into the building, went to Starbucks, and then I saw the same guy ordering coffee, and I'm like, okay, quite a coincidence. Also, as soon as I get to the table, he walks off, stands in the corner, doesn't say anything, ordered my coffee, went back, and then the third time that week, I came in, and I saw the same guy at the table, and I thought, okay, this might not be a coincidence. And then I ordered my coffee, he was standing in the corner, and as I left, I look back and I see him go back to Liz. I was like, okay, he must be, you know, liking Liz or something. And so the next week I walked in, saw Effie standing there, and Liz was like, okay, I would like to introduce you to someone. And she said, yeah, this is my friend Effie. I said, friend, sure. And now, what, 2 years later, we're standing here and they're married. As a brother, just Effie, take care of Liz. I know he will. He has done that since the moment that they met, just enjoying life together and just keep loving each other. That's it.
Ever since I've met them as a couple, they've always been extremely, just a very fun couple that I've always looked up to. They always do fun things together and are always very happy when they're around each other. So I would just say keep that spark going, keep doing the fun things. Even though it seems insignificant, those are the things that keep you happy. So yeah, just remain being a child. Yeah.
Okay, let me share the mark. There we go. Most people call me Coach, but my name is actually Casey Bradstreet, and your name is? David?
Rick.
Bradstreet. That is correct. I was first Liz's coach, but now we are friends and staff members together, so we are the coaching staff. She is one of the most loyal people I've ever met, so her dedication comes out in the way that she's committed to the individual, the cause. The commitment that she has made is very evident in her sacrificial loyalty that she displays every day.
Effie is basically my little brother. This was in 2020. He was really into airplanes, and he would sit outside in the back porch and watch the airplanes. He'd say, Livy, look at this airplane. And he'd say, this is a Boeing 2700 or whatever. I don't know any of the numbers. And for his birthday, I took him to a local airport so he could watch the airplane take off and then end. I was a little surprised that I had to get that information out of him myself and he didn't just call me and tell me. Well, I called Effie and asked him how his life was going. And then he said, oh, by the way, I'm engaged. He was hiding that secret for like a month. He didn't tell anyone. In 2021, Effie said, remind me that I have challenged myself to stay single for the next 2 years. I will look for a relationship only in 2023. Well, he met Liz in 2021. He didn't stick to that at all. Which I guess is a good thing, otherwise we wouldn't be here. Oh, when Liz, Effie, and I were driving through Winchester for the first time together, we passed a Indian restaurant called Taste of India, and Liz goes, Taste of India. And Effie goes, that most definitely is not. All that really matters to me are s'mores. And I'll leave you with that quote.
My kids met her and were obsessed with her. They could immediately tell she was perfect.
Always. She's always been the king.
I met Effie in India when he was 9.
I must have met him about a year later. So creative. He always showed us all around Cody Connell and took me to some interesting places around the city and on hikes.
I was supposed to teach him violin, but he did not want to learn violin. I think of my memories of very young Effie are him bursting into the room I was staying in and wanting to use the TV to watch Jackie Chan. He loved Jackie Chan.
My first memory with Effie is him showing me films as well. And we watched Kung Fu Panda 3 in India, and it was awesome.
Okay. Oh, I feel so... Why did they let us do this? We're like teenagers.
We're teenagers.
We're like babies. They let us get married.
I like face on. I put my lip up into my teeth.
Yeah, I could tell you little buck teeth.
I was so and worried
then,
about that.
And then I was like, my cheeks like cramped up and they got stuck. I was like,
oh no.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I feel great. I got a cramp. I was so stressed out. I got a cramp in my thigh. I don't know how that happens, but here we are. But let me tell you something. Do not get Facebook Live and do not try to teach your family members how to use Facebook Live. It is a pain. But overall, it was great. I'm not gonna lie, it was great. I better start working for an airline because I am gonna lose all my money just for vacations, traveling to 3 different countries. So that's what I think I'm have to do. But other than that, it's kind of fun that I get to travel to 3 different places. I've only been to the United States, so now, you know, going to South Africa would be awesome. If you talk about citizenship now, it's either between South Africa or US, so we'll see.
I'm excited. I'm much more relaxed than I thought I would be, which is really good.
I think it is very special to see different cultures being represented. We try to incorporate a little bit of everything, but obviously it's a little hard. This is my sister. She's been taking my pictures for forever. So we knew that we wanted someone who we can relax with, who will be calm and tell us honestly what we need to do. And she just loves taking our pictures, so it's really exciting.
Oh, when she told me that I'm gonna be the photographer, I was so nervous because I only do it on the side. I didn't like do much of it, but yeah, it was not that bad. I feel like the pictures are pretty nice, but yeah, it was a bit stressful. No.
You gotta take that money, girl.
I need the money, but it's right.
He's a very adaptable guy. So he informed me first before he could tell he's the whole family. For the whole family, we had all our expectations. He's the only guy in my family. The rest of them are girls. So we wanted to find him a bride, do this, do that, and all those things. But we accepted it. As a family, I gave the news that he's getting a girl from South Africa. And it was quite good. They accepted Liz very well. Todd knows my family very well, the whole family, his wife and children. So he gave a very good recommendation that, Dempsey, you cannot find a better bride to Effie than Liz. That put us all at ease.
It's been said by some in our family that it's hard to capture exactly who Effie is. You just have to more experience him. We received the full Effie experience in 2020. He was flying an airplane from Asia to the US, and then he had to pay attention to the flight the entire time, so 15 to 18 hours to make sure that they didn't crash. And he took it very seriously. He goes, I can't go, I have to fly the plane. That's a little crazy. You're joyful. There's not a morning you come down where you're not cheerful. You know, extremely helpful in any way anybody could ever ask. And we met Liz in the winter of 2022. That was the first time she came to our house. She came with Effie. We immediately loved her because of a couple things. Incredibly gracious, very easy to be with, and of course, she's super helpful at organizing Effie's life. So, there is no more lovely, friendly, and charming relationship, communions, or company than a good marriage. When Christ tells us to love our neighbor, he's telling us first to love our spouse, who is our closest neighbor. That's a point of truth.
Something that we do know is there's always a lot of food at our weddings. Yep. I'm glad there's a lot of food here. and we're really very proud of Zadri. I think I'm going to share two quick stories about Zadri. The one is, when she was still fairly small, she was about 6 or 7, I think she just started going to school. It was in South Africa, and we've got a mountain range in South Africa called the Dragon's Mountain Range, because it looks like a dragon's back. And because we are really creative people in South Africa, we decided to call it the Dragon's Mountain. So it had snowed in the winter, and if it snowed, and when it snows on mountains, and it snowed on Dragon's Mountain. So Elmery was talking to Zandra, and says, call your brother and sister, tell them to come inside. It's snowed on the mountains, on the Dragon's Mountains, and it's going to be cold, so we better come inside. And Zadri's always had these huge eyes, and the eyes went even bigger than normal. And she ran to her brother and sister and said, the snow dragons are on their way. We have to go inside. So I think let's toast the happy couple to you two, Zadri and Effie. May you have wonderful years. May you always be a page.
You've got to talk. No, I'm not talking. I've given my speech. Now it's your turn.
I'm not a speechy type.
That was a good speech.
Sure? Yeah, I'm very speech? Sure. I'm very sure. Sam told us he watched his call, and then a bird messed on it just as he was coming to meet us. So he was so nervous, so upset about that. And we, not knowing him, we could see he was upset. And he was very nervous. But then
I remember him seeing you and being thinking you're all nice, and then he saw me and I was standing at the top of the stairs and he thought I'm quite big.
No, and he had this red car that he polished and we just got along.
I think we were very pleased and grateful and glad. We like Effie. We think he'll be a good husband for our daughter. And that's what every parent's looking at, is the spouse that their child's going to marry. Is that going to be a good person for them? Is it going to make them better or worse? And I'm sure if he's making Zandri better, and we believe that she does the same for him. So we're very happy.
I first met Liz. She moved into my apartment. I was kind of worried at first because I had a cat, and you never know with new roommates if they're going to like. Bella ended up loving them. I remember one of the first days that they were just hanging out in their room and it was time to go to bed, and Bella went into their bedroom instead of coming with me. And I was just like, ah, darn. But they ended up loving Bella. Like I said, Bella loved them so much so that they even adopted a Bella, which was absolutely amazing and a really good home for them. That being one of the first memories of them. And ever since then, you know, we've been playing pickleball, having good times, and been a very, very good couple to kind of do life with.
You done? Awesome. Yeah. Guys, I just want to say to you, congratulations. I really just hope you guys find peace in everything that you do, in any endeavors that you guys take on, that, you know, you guys are just blessed in all of that. Like Jordan mentioned with pickleball, you know, we've enjoyed playing that with you guys. And yeah, hopefully we get a bunch more games in while we're in Campbellsville. All I'm going to say is that one win that you guys have got is your only one.
I knew Liz in Starbucks during that time. It was kind of chaotic. Both of us would come in and complain about the other people not actually stocking Starbucks itself. But summer 2021 was when I first started to get to know him. So we'd play sand volleyball with him pretty much nearly every single night. And he'd always be at 7 a.m. running around campus like a maniac. The first encounter with both of them together, they were at Starbucks late at night. And I'd offered Liz a ride home and she was like, no, I'm actually talking to Effie at this stage. I was like, okay, I'll leave you be. Well, it was actually last summer, I didn't really take notice too much. I was lifeguarding with Liz was above me as the boss, and then Effie was one of the lifeguards as well. And we were walking into the field house for our GA meeting, and I saw Liz open the door and she had the ring on her finger. And I was like, no way, what is this? She was like, yeah, we got engaged. Like, I've been trying to show it off to you subtly at Starbucks when you're working. You just never noticed. So I noticed it like a week later because I was oblivious to it. I think, obviously, both of you are competitive. Effie gets a little bit more competitive with his pickleball. So Effie, still be competitive, but maybe tame it a little bit. And then Liz, just if Effie's annoying you, you could just slap the pickleball at him if you need to.
I think Liz is better at pickleball. I've known Effie pretty much since 2018 when we both started off as freshmen. We had a lot of the same classes together and we would talk every once in a while. He was super nice. So that was my first impression of him, like super nice on top of his studies and everything. Like what he said, be competitive, don't get too mean like she does sometimes, but just enjoy the time together, basically.
Now my privilege to, for the first time, introduce to you, Mr. and Mrs. Ephraim Michael. 1, 2, 3, 4.